Hey, good morning, everybody. I hope y'all had a great night last night. Slept well, first night in the hotel. Got an exciting day for you here today, and as a fervent Volkswagen enthusiast myself, I have the unique pleasure of being the product manager for the GTI and Golf R models for the United States. Something that I definitely don't take lightly, and with that, we have an all-new Golf R and GTI, of course, the eighth generation of our Golf models, which represent almost 40 years of history for GTI alone. Now, with GTI and Golf R, this is something that we've not had the opportunity to drive in terms of the US spec vehicles, so this will be the first opportunity to have some Americans behind the wheel of US spec Golf R and GTI. So just to make that clear, these are the GTIs and the Golf Rs for our market. But I think it's important when we start with GTI that this is the all-around vehicle that represents doing everything well and having fun while doing it, and that is Golf GTI at its heart. Now, nearly 40 years ago, when GTI entered the shores here in the US, of course, we called it a rabbit GTI back then, it represented something that wasn't really previously available for Americans. It was a compact vehicle, fuel efficient, German engineered, really fun to drive. And those are four elements that have carried through every single generation of GTI. And I believe it's quite clear when you have the opportunity to drive the all-new 8th generation one today that you'll see that it still holds true to those values. Now, way back in 1983, whopping 90 horsepower, four-cylinder motor, 1.8 liter, normally aspirated, five-speed manual. But back then, you didn't really need much more than that. The car was fun to drive, great to toss around the corners. It had some elements that we see even on today's GTI, whether it's the golf ball-shaped shift knob, the red accents on the interior and the exterior, and of course, the signature plaid sports seat upholstery. But again, fast forward to today, you have a vehicle that, of course, weighs about twice as much as the previous GTI, so it needs to have a lot more power to go along with that. And I think you'll find that the power is quite ample for the new GTI. We have the fourth generation of our EA888 direct injection four-cylinder motor, now with 241 horsepower, and of note, that's the same standard horsepower for every GTI in the world. So there are no compromises when it comes to this Wolfsburg-built eighth generation GTI. 273 pound-feet of torque available across a very nice broad torque band. And then of course, because this is a driving enthusiast vehicle and we see that among GTI customers, one of their top three purchase reasons is availability of manual transmission. Of course, a six-speed manual transmission remains available on the vehicle, as of course, the fantastic Volkswagen seven-speed DSG dual clutch automatic. One thing that makes this GTI so head and shoulders above the previous generation GTI is a new vehicle dynamics setting system. This new module essentially marries together and harmonizes every electromechanic chassis component of the GTI, whether it's the XDS cross differential, the VAQ front differential, which still remains standard on the vehicle, and of course the available DCC active chassis control. Now on the GTI equipped with DCC, one thing where that new vehicle dynamics system really shines is it can adjust each individual damper up to 200 times per second. So that's going to give you the best, most engaged driving experience ever in a GTI. Now, of course, in terms of design, you still have some trademark GTI elements, as with every single generation of the past. Red grille line, red accents, GTI-ness throughout the exterior as well as the interior. You have a signature illuminated LED light bar, so you'll recognize that from some other newer Volkswagen models, whether it's the ID.4 or the Arteon. You also have full LED lighting standard on GTI, as well as some nice signature X-shaped LED fog lights, which play into the GTI honeycomb heritage element. So everybody will recognize the nighttime lighting signature of the new GTI. Of course, red painted brake calipers, some nice design throughout, and for the first time in North America, an optional 19-inch alloy wheel from the factory. Taking it into the interior of a GTI, it's always a good time inside, and now more than ever, we have a new digital InnoVision cockpit, which for the driver gives a completely new experience all the way around, whether it's the 30-color ambient lighting that extends all throughout the interior of the vehicle. You have a light and sight panel to the left, which has touch controls for all of your lighting elements, your defrost elements, basically anything that helps you to see better and to be seen. Straight in front of you, you've got a digital cockpit pro as standard, so first time we have digital cockpit for a GTI in the US. Available heads-up display. And then over to the right, an all-new MIB3 infotainment display ranging from 8 to 10 inches in size, fully configurable, really customizable. I believe many of you have spent time already in ID4. So it's a similar architecture to the infotainment system in ID4, but with some additional customization elements specific for GTI and that driving experience with the enthusiast customer. And of course, you continue to have the newer feature standard on GTI, whether it's an all-new Harman Kardon premium audio system, and of course, the Vienna leather seats that are both heated as well as ventilated. Again, a first for GTI, so that's pretty nice. Now, GTI has always been not only a value-packed vehicle for us, but also something that represents kind of the pinnacle of something for everybody, as I mentioned earlier. Now, GTI still starts at under $30,000 for the manual transmission, $29,545. That's only $850 more than the outgoing 7th generation GTI. And when you look at all the equipment that's newly standard on the vehicle, from the performance upgrades to the new MQB architecture to the almost near luxury level of equipment, as well as Volkswagen's IQ Drive advanced driver assistance systems as standard, I think it's pretty clear that even the GTI S is a full-grown value for the performance customer. Now, the SE represents our most commonly chosen GTI among enthusiast customers. So you'll see we've got a lot of nice equipment there, as well as two packages with the leather seat ventilation package, as well as some black wheels. And then, of course, the fully loaded Autobahn trim, as always. Basically, anything you can get in a performance hatchback, you will find in the GTI Autobahn. But speaking of performance hatchback, I would be remiss if I didn't go ahead and give some great accolades to the all-new Golf R. So you will, of course, have the opportunity to drive the Golf R today as well. This is our fifth iteration of an R model in the United States, a version that's been around, or I should say, kind of a model line that's been around for almost 20 years altogether. So let's take it back to where it began for our performance halo. If you recall the 2004 model year Golf R32, a model that's very near and dear to my heart. I happen to own one, drive one, love one. It takes all my time and money. But this is a great car for us. It was the first time that we had married together a VR6 motor, four-motion all-wheel drive, six-speed manual, put it all together in a hatchback. And hence, the R heritage was born. So this was a unique car for us. Again, only 5,000 or 5,017 units to be exact were imported and sold into the United States, manual transmission only, four different colors, some signature seats, an awesome interior, and this really nice exhaust note that happens to sound eerily similar to a furry character from a George Lucas movie. So it's got a really nice exhaust note as well. So the R32 set a standard that every single R model after has tried to capture. And I do truly feel that for the first time with an R model, the all-new Golf R really captures that emotion, heritage, passion, and driving dynamics of the original R32. With this model, we continue with the four-cylinder turbo idea, and this is now still the EA AAA motor. It's just the fourth generation now. Finally crested beyond 300 horsepower, so we're at 315 and up to 295 pound-feet of torque when equipped with the DSG. Now, speaking of transmissions, once again, Golf R customers choose manual transmission almost hand over fist over manual. Some months it's nearly 50-50. So it was very important for us to retain the six-speed manual transmission for this model. It's not only one of the greatest buying motivations for a Golf R customer here in the US, but also is what the competition offers, whether it's the Honda Civic Type R, Subaru WRX STI. And also interesting to note is that the US and Canada are the only markets in the world for this Golf R generation to receive the six-speed manual transmission. Also, of course, 7-speed DSG is available, and the DSG is a peach in this Golf R. It is so much fun to drive as well. Again, fun to drive being a huge hallmark for not only the GTI, but also the Golf R. The same great performance benefits that help bolster the new GTI do play into the Golf R as well, whether it's the new vehicle dynamic setting system, the DCC adjustable damper system, etc. One thing I didn't mention on GTI, which is important for both models, I think, is how the revised MQB platform has been strengthened and lightened thanks to the use of an aluminum subframe, which helps shave off nearly 7 pounds of unsprung weight while increasing the rigidity of the platform itself. So that is going to play into the driving dynamics of both vehicles. Speaking of driving dynamics, we have an all-new torque vectoring all-wheel drive system for Golf R. So this takes the place of the old Haldex-based all-wheel drive system. We now have a Magna-produced torque vectoring all-wheel drive unit. It takes that same amount of 50% maximum power from the front axle to transfer to the rear, but now the story can continue thanks to torque vectoring, which can transfer up to 100% of power to an individual rear wheel. That not only helps make the vehicle tremendously more fun to toss around corners and drive responsibly, you know, fun down the road, but it also helps make sure that we can make the most of two new driving modes, a drift mode as well as a special mode, which you might notice a little Nürburgring logo and green color theming on the interior when you choose the special track mode. These two new drive features are standard on the Golf R as well as the other four driving modes, and you'll find that the Golf R really has multiple personalities in a good way at this point. Each driving mode is so categorically different from the other that you can really just perfectly cater the Golf R to whatever driving experience you want. So similar to GTI, it's important that you have some heritage elements on the exterior that say this is a Golf R, whether it's the blue accents, the blue calipers, the R logos, the blue lines, the new illuminated grille, the aggressively larger cross-drilled brakes that are no longer shared with GTI. These are Golf R only brakes, two piston calipers, dual piece rotors, cross-drilled as you can see, and again they are specific to Golf R, so they definitely help because, you know, with great power you need to have great control. The new brakes definitely help with that. On the interior, basically everything you can get on a Volkswagen you'll find standard on a Golf R. Don't need to go through the list with you there, but you can imagine whether it's ambient lighting, the heads-up display, digital cockpit, ventilated heated seats, heated rear seats, Harman Kardon, etc. Everything is standard on Golf R. It's really a one-stop shop, which I'll show you up here. You basically choose your transmission, choose your color, motor off, enjoy your car, and that's been a philosophy for Golf R that has worked with our customers to just have it be a one-stop, fully loaded vehicle. You can see that it represents tremendous value compared to the outgoing model. For about $2,000 more compared to the outgoing model, you have a great deal more performance, you have a great deal more standard features. We have items we've never before offered on any Volkswagen model in the US, let alone a Golf R, and that is our performance pinnacle and a model that we can all be really proud of.